Madam, we'll turn the meeting over to let you start.
Okay. Well, the first item on the agenda is the discussion of the renewal of the annual contract with Logan County Economic Development. And this is an item that the council talked about during the budget session, expressed a desire for the vice mayor and I to meet with Kay and some of her board members to discuss the scope of services and the scope of monetary reimbursement or monetary pledge from the city in light of economic development changes that we've got internally. And the vice mayor and I met with representatives from the board, and they desired to come meet with the entire council in a workshop setting. So
cool.
I think the vice mayor's actually done a little bit more legwork on this than me, so if you don't mind, I'll turn it over to you.
Yeah, that's fine. I think one of the things I met, had the luxury of meeting with Jan this afternoon, in fact, and I'll let them speak to some of the points. Do you want to just...
Go ahead.
And you know, so I think some of the concerns the council had, and we addressed it a little bit in depth today, was, you know, one of the things that we're getting was, what are we getting for the $18,000 as a city, and what are we seeing from it? And so it kind of stressed that point from the council's position, is that, you know, we can come to some agreement, not an all or nothing deal here, but some type of concession in the price a little bit somewhere, but more importantly, that we're actually seeing either a quarterly update or a monthly update or some type of update status from them, from LCEDC, to kind of give it, so let us know where we're at. We get a quarterly report from the chamber. I think we probably deserve kind of the same reporting scenario from LCEDC, and I think that they would probably openly agree that probably that's something that's been lacking in the past. And then I think the third item that I was really wanted to stress to their board was, I think the council would like to see them come before the council on each budget session, and so we're not just having a perpetual number that everybody assumes is going to roll over, but we have a number that they're coming explaining why they're looking for X amount of dollars in that next year's budget, so we can have that discussion in the workshop form. I think, does that kind of wrap up a little bit what we talked about?
Well, aren't they real important to our small business here in town?
Yeah, nobody...
I mean, without them, they'd be in a world of hurt.
And nobody's making that argument. I think the point is that there's a couple of items we wanted to see, which was, you know, if they can make some concessions on the price, if there's room to wiggle, we'd like to try to talk about that. Second off, can we get some type of reporting progress in place so we do know, so we're not sitting here next year saying, well, what did we get for our money? You know, we'd like to have an idea.
Well, from what I looked at, they could probably use more money on a budget. That'd be the truthful part of it.
Well, and I'll let them make that request, not myself. But the point is that I think we...
I didn't mean anything bad there. Yeah. I'm just saying that I think they do a great job for a little bit of money that they do, and I wish there was some way we could give them more money.
I wish we could give everybody more money. More rooms and all those things that go along with it, but I think that at the point of where we're at today is that we can put some measures in place in order that we're not sitting here this time next year going, what are we getting, what have we gotten? I think we all know in a roundabout way some projects that they've worked on in the past, but this is a good way to open up that dialogue moving forward. So with that, I'll let Jan give a presentation, or Kay.
I'm going to let Kay go first.
Okay. Well, I'd just like to start out by saying this is not the year to cut the budget, because not only do we have to repay the money to the USDA principal and interest that we've borrowed from them, that we have loaned to the businesses over the last 15 years. We've loaned to about 70 different businesses over the last 15 years. All of the business loans have been good. They have repaid. We have re-loaned it to other businesses. We have loaned to plenty of businesses downtown and plenty of retailers. In fact, we have 3 loans right now in the downtown area. As you'll recall, the $100,000 grant that we got for the city of Guthrie is to be used specifically to loan to businesses downtown. And that's money you all don't have to pay back. You can keep revolving and loaning that to other businesses as it's repaid. At the end of this year, you'll have $50,000 you can loan if somebody needs, you know, new windows on the front, or if they need to work on something inside, you know, you can use that for smaller loans. And then that comes back to you. But you don't have to pay that back. We do. And not only that, but we have any loans that are not bad, that are not good, we still have to pay back to the USDA. And so this year, we are not going to only be paying back the $75,000 loan for the chamber that was done several years ago before Mary was ever there. But the money that the Blount Memorial Foundation had borrowed from us and was unable to repay. And so, I mean, that is almost $200,000 we have to repay to the USDA on top of repaying the loan money. So we do have money, we have more money to loan, but it is money that's already been revolved and come back to us. And, you know, to lose, the reason your funding is critical this year is that to lose that, we're going to have to start dipping into our revolved funds. And that is money to use for businesses. We have 26 loans out right now. They have borrowed about $2 million. They've invested that in the community. Over the last 3 years, those businesses have created 103 jobs. And when I'm saying jobs, you know, I mean, all of us have, you all have jobs. You know that's important to have jobs. Jobs are what support families. That Logan County has a huge public sector payroll, and it's like $187 million a year. And it is the private sector employers and employees who live in this county that make that public sector payroll. So, you know, it's the small businesses are absolutely essential to a community, and particularly a community like this. I can go on and on, but I won't, because I think you do realize that I certainly we would be happy to report quarterly. A lot of the things that we do are confidential. Only Renee knows about, because I work closely with Renee. But we can't talk about them in public at all. And we have fielded many RFPs from mid-sized manufacturers who we'd love to have here. We fielded many inquiries and called many retailers that we would like to have here. And I can tell you, any major retailer is going to that sells some of the big ticket items that we need in this county, they look at jobs, households, population, household income. That's their first screen. That's the first screen. Renee knows that, because we have written packages to answer RFPs. All kinds of requests that we receive constantly from the Department of Commerce. But, you know, we've got to maintain the jobs that we have. And 80% of the jobs are created by businesses you already have in your community. And those are the businesses that these companies that borrow money don't do it just for the fun of it. They do it when they're ready to expand, buy a new piece of equipment, and that causes them to hire more people. So that I'll turn it over to any. This is my board, and it's a committed board. Again, we'd be happy to report as often as you want, and, you know, stay closer with the council. I think that has been a mistake, but we'll sure be happy to do that and tell you what we can tell you.
Hi, I'm Jan Goodyear, and as Kay said, I'm one of the board members. I'm also a board member with Mary on the Chamber of Commerce, board member with Logan County Economic Development Association as well, Industrial Development Authority, excuse me, as well. And these people that are sitting around you are all about the growth of our community, of Guthrie, Logan County, the quality of life. And I want to make the differentiation, or maybe the want to make sure the statement is made. Kay talks about businesses. I'm going to go a little bit more defined and say industrial businesses and retail businesses. There's no difference to our organization, and there's really no difference to the chamber and Mary that we're all about trying to grow Guthrie. Whether that person that walks into our office is a retailer or an industrial person, that's what it's all about. That's what we try to grow. As a realtor, I get a lot of not so much industrial, although I get some. I get more of the retail sector. Without question, the first person that person talks to is Kay, every time, because of what her knowledge of people in the community and around the state. She can hook people up with the right people, and the grant money, or not grant money, the loan money that we have to help businesses. That makes all the difference in the world for a lot of mom and pop businesses that come in. I've talked to the franchises, I've talked to the big players just like Kay has, and our numbers aren't there yet. We may get there someday, and hopefully we will, where we can have a Lowe's or whatever you want to talk about. But in the interim, we've got to grow with what we have. And we've got to have businesses that are paying sales tax and creating revenue for our community. And, you know, Kay is a valuable asset in the organization. You know, the funny part is, and John brought this up when we were talking before, actually when Kay was hired and Alba Weaver had left the city, the city's commitment was they would give us $25,000 a year to pay for Kay's salary. And that has come down to where it's at today. And it's not going to be fun, but we're willing to let something go or agree to like a 3-year cut. But we've got to have time to create other sources, because as John has already told most of you, we're going to be at a deficit this year. We're going to have to dip into that fund and take away money that could go out to retail businesses in this town to help them grow. And that's a shame. And this isn't the end of the world, and it won't be the end of the world for us. But, you know, one thing I think we need to do more of is work together as a team. And we all need to work together. We all need to help each other. We all need to grow together. And if we can just get a vision and a feeling for that, I think it would be, we'd have a different community. We would change. And, you know, we can work with Cody, and Cody can work with us. Mary and Kay work together every day, and they're right in the same building. So we need to do more of that, and we need your help. We need the city council's commitment and help to make all of this stay fit, stay profitable, stay where it needs to be. You know, but I think Sylvia, we talked a little bit ago, and Sylvia's a real estate person just like I am, and we use Kay all the time. Sure, we use Mary. Sure, we use Renee. But the Economic Development Council offers something that they can only offer. Nobody else has that. And so I would appreciate your consideration. We need it. We're asking for it. We're as much a part of retail as any organization that I know of. John, you want to talk a little bit about...
Well, I'd rather close up. I mean,
okay, close up.
But I don't know. Go ahead. Kay, who else did you want?
Laverne wanted to say something, I think.
Well, it's kind of like council members Trey and Patty were saying, they'd like to have enough money to give to everything that needs to be funded and such, and we appreciate that. We want you to know we are sensitive to budget issues that the city has, and we realize there's just not a money tree growing over here, so we want you to know we're sensitive to that. A couple of other things I would point out, back to the Tyler Blunt Memorial Foundation situation that we're in, the money that we loaned was on city property for the rodeo arena, and we think we've got a really nice rodeo arena there now, and we appreciate the city council's efforts to work with the EDC on that situation and the lease that's involved, but it is the city's property, and the EDC invested a lot of money in that. Another thing that maybe shouldn't be brought up because it didn't work out the best, but there was a little venture called, I think, Excel Jet at one time that the city was interested in trying to get off the ground, so to speak, and the EDC wanted to help with that, and we did, and we were glad to do it. But my point is we feel like we've had a really strong partnership with the city. We just want to keep that, and not only with loans that we've made in the past, but loans that we think we would like to make going forward. And I think, as Kay pointed out to me in an earlier discussion, that our office has helped with some CDBG grants that the city was trying to get. I think one of them was for the sewer replacement in the southeast quadrant. And so anyway, we want to be your partner. As Jan said, we need your help, but we're sensitive to what the city needs to do too. So that's my case.
Go ahead, John.
Well, I don't have much to add to any of that, but, and I don't know if you guys have been given this. Kay's made a summary here of some of the $30,000 for the apothecary garden, $1 million EDA grant for the water and sewer, $350,000 CDBG grant for the construction of Spirit Wing Hangar, $100,000 grant, $250,000 and 0% interest loan, $100,000 USDA RBEC grant, $250,000 CDBG grant for the city sewer. I guess to me it's really simple. You know, I've been involved in the EDC since the early 90s. We had an opportunity to hire Kay about 3 years ago, and you know, the city had a couple economic development people, which, you know, is fine, but it hadn't worked out real well for them. What we did is we partnered with the city to hire Kay, and the city committed $25,000 a year. The fact is we operate on negative cash flow, and we need the $25,000. We understand you've cut, but our it's just the more we get cut, the closer the demise of our organization is. And what I would say is, when you're cutting your budget, you know, it's always tempting to cut everywhere, but it's always a mistake to cut even in times of hardship. The last place you want to cut is where you're getting a positive return on your investment. I think you're getting a positive return on your investment with EDC. And I think Jim or somebody brought up, yeah, like MAPS in Oklahoma City. Who wanted to do that when the economy was bad? But look what it's done. And part of our problem is there's not a lot of PR. I mean, we brought up some things over in our, when we gathered up before we came over here, that we really can't say in public. But we've created 109 jobs in the last 3 years. Now folks, the sales tax off of that's more, off of that employment is more than $25,000 a year. If you went out and hired these grants written, that's a lot of money. So I think you're getting a positive return on your investment. It's been a good partnership. I mean, we have loaned the Public Works Authority money several times on short notice to acquire properties and do different things. We're over there and ready to do it again. I think you're getting a positive return on your investment. It's one of the best investments the city is making. So, okay.
Can I say something? My name is Stroud. I'm in a manufacturing company in Oklahoma City. I'm from Mulhall. It's just north of here. I'm an engineer. I'm the CEO of a manufacturing company. We've got plants in this country. I've got a plant in England. In about 2 weeks, we'll have one in China. I'm not going to talk to mechanical and reporting. Yeah, we can do that. We should have been doing it all along. But you've got a situation here that people are putting not employees to work, but families. If there was more skilled labor, my plant would be here, and there's not, and we're trying to change that. This is nothing compared to the, and of course I can't give the numbers out because they're proprietary for the loan people, whatever they call it. But if you were to see those numbers or have somebody that could look at them, you not only wouldn't cut it, you would actually add to it. This is run by volunteers. We have one employee. I think you'd be silly to get rid of this. This is not a good business move. And that's all there is to it. It's just business. And I understand you have to make cuts. I understand that. But you also, you know, what's the old story? You don't kill the goose what's laying the golden egg. And everybody needs funds. I understand that too. But you got to look where it's going and the return on it. The ROI is very good with this operation. It just doesn't make sense to not have that because there's other places aren't contributing and we are.
I have one last comment. I appreciate your comments, and as we, as a council, move forward, we've extracted more information today from EDC than we've probably received in the last 3 years. So my point being that 109 jobs, quantifying that is exactly the kind of information we want to hear. That's not proprietary. That's not confidential.
No, it's not.
Those are the points that I'm trying to make, that in order for us to continue on being good stewards of the citizens' cash, we have to know those kind of things in order to be able to do that. And if you can recognize that from the position of the council's position, that's what we're looking for. I don't need to know every Tom, Dick, and Harry company that's coming that's on a potential. We just need to know that so many have been reached or trying to be reached in a you know, a 10,000-foot overview.
Yeah.
Because, and I'm being honest, this is the most information I've had extracted out of LCEDC since I've been on the council happened tonight.
And most of us work in the quiet.
I understand that. But when I'm dealing with the public's money, and so...
Well, we should have asked a long time ago, bottom line.
So the point, is that we need that level.
Yes.
I mean, you guys report to investors. Unfortunately, I report to 3,600 individuals within my ward, and when they ask the question, we have to be able to be cognizant with that answer. And so, with that being said, I think we're on the right track. I'd love to see. I assume the council would be behind. I don't want to be one person speaking for on behalf of everybody, but I think everybody agrees that we need to have a level of reporting. And I think you guys need to come to budget meetings and explain to lay out your next year, what your forecast is. Do you have a pipeline to reach X amount of folks as we're moving forward, so we can be understanding of where this cash is going to. So
we can sure do that.
Okay. I appreciate it.
Does the county bring any money in, or is it just us? We're the
this
carriers.
One now?
The county, do you get money
the county
from the
itself?
County at all? It's Logan County Economic Development. We've just wondered if they put anything in the pot.
Well, I don't think the county itself gives anything, do they, Kay?
No.
But the reason it's the Logan County Economic Development Council is, you know, if we get a big manufacturing plant in Mulhall or Crescent, it's a countywide impact. I mean, the fact is, Guthrie is the shopping hub. Guthrie's the hub. Guthrie, in many ways, is the direct beneficiary of probably 90% of what we do, even though we have helped with the project in Mulhall that's created, you know, what's probably now 97% of their sales tax base. So we've helped other communities, but Guthrie is the primary beneficiary.
So. Can I comment?
And the county in sales taxes, so schools.
During the tornado, Cashin was completely, the south side of Cashin was wiped out. As a small community, our Lions Club put together is only $12,000, but it was done through a local store here rather than going to Oklahoma City, just because of my ties through the Logan County Economic Development. That's the ties that you're wanting to see. But it was $12,000, and it was all brought right here. They didn't have any place else to go. It was with a voucher.
Can I note something? I just want to say that, you know, I've talked to Kay as well. I think these are good folks who are looking for growth in the county. It seems like they're actually focused more in Guthrie than the name belies there. And, you know, we do have to be, what Trey said, we have to be fiscally responsible. But the key to that, as a government entity, you have to be transparent and accountable. And I think we do this line by line or a budget, and I think this is, you know, it's about time we do that with the LCDC. But I think that, you know, one thing is I think that it's a great benefit. There's a lot of people, a lot of entities who couldn't get loans otherwise than through this organization. At the same time, this idea, and I brought this up with Kay, it is Logan County. I would like to see you guys maybe approach Logan County and just say, hey, we benefit the whole county, and if we got a little more, we could really benefit the whole county, and it would grow. And I think it would be nice to see Logan County contribute. And I'm not saying we'd lessen our side of things because of that, but I think we'd actually feel more comfortable if we saw Logan County contribute. I think that's been one of my concerns, is that we're giving all this money, but not everybody's doing the same thing, and they're all benefiting.
Let me make one response to Trey and to you in that respect. Our board is made up of different businesses that are represented. In fact, Jim's with OG&E from Oklahoma City, and then we've got people around the county as well. We have always had a board position for the Guthrie City Manager, and he is on our board. And you know, and that will always be the case. And the reason that has been put in that way is because of your commitment and investment to us. We want the city manager or his representative or her representative, whatever the case may be, to be involved. And we welcome that. And, you know, I know Renee comes once in a while, and I know we all have busy schedules, and our meetings are at 7:30 in the morning, which are kind of tough. But that's what we do because of our different business people. But we have no qualms with however you want this information brought forward to you. We have tried to be, we've never tried to hide anything. We've always tried to make you a part of our organization, and we will continue to do so.
Absolutely, and I think that is an excellent idea, and I can assure you that we will be visiting with the county regarding that.
Sounds great.
All right, I'm going to jump in here because I know we're working in a really time constraint here this evening. Can we jump quickly to the, Mr. Mayor, I'll let you do it and jump us in the agenda items for...
Can I, real quick though, just to housekeeping's sake, for how, because this agreement expires October 1st, next, so the next meeting you have will be the one where you'll need to reconsider all of your annual renewals for all of, you know, for the CBB, and how would you best like to organize the working out the fine details of the agreement? Would you and Jan and Kay like to get together? I mean, how would you?
Would you guys like to get together?
Is there any input? From the council. I mean, it's going to be very inefficient to try to hammer out the line by line details of a contract in a large group setting like this. But is there any input that the council needs to give the vice mayor before they take? Before he works with them for the details of the agreement, because it does need to be on the next agenda, otherwise it will not be in place October 1st.
Well, I think Trey's got the great angle on this, and I think you should just proceed with it. And the dialogue's been opened, and it needs to stay open now, and that's a great move. So Trey's got the right thing.
I trust Trey will do a good job.
Yeah, I agree. Matt, I think all of us on the board probably want to see the council grow. I don't want to cut it back. I want to see it grow, because otherwise we're not going to get the sales tax return if we don't grow Guthrie. I mean, why lower it now when we need it more than ever? I mean, I'm willing to give up anything to help them attain the jobs that will make this city grow. I mean, if we don't look at it like that, it's all over. And the fat lady hadn't sang yet, so let's get in here and help and make it work. And I think we can.
Well, sure, he'll take that under advisement.
Sometime we'll try to put something together.
And Wanda can work with you as far as the agreement itself in its current form, and then the input, whatever additional language you guys work.
Lovely, Wanda.
Not for long.
Thank you. Thanks for enduring.
We appreciate
your talk. We'd like to have this many people
turn out for
the next Blue Jay game.
Get in there, buddy. That's a packed house. Thank you, sir. Thanks for speaking.
Thank you.
See you there.
Can I address the deannexation item on the agenda? I didn't ask the only one. I think is, my personal view is that it was set in place in 68 for a reason. I know there's probably alternative views from it, but it was set in place as a buffer, keeping from Edmund from jumping over the curve, if you will. I'd like to, my personal opinion is to pull it off of the agenda completely, but that's just my perspective on the deal. I don't see the reasoning, and somebody can enlighten me on why it's there to begin with.
Well, I have a lot of questions about it, and I'd like to pull it too. I'm not comfortable with it at all.
I agree.
Matt did give us some pros and cons to it a while back.
Gosh, we've got back some, when we were looking at that.
We save money on chemicals, and there's
we could actually do a whole workshop on just that, because there are too many factors into what's going on with
I've
that.
Already gotten a lot of calls today just saying, hey, why is this, and why are we, you know, I don't have a really good solid answer without just delving into it a little bit, so I'd like to see us yank it, but that's...
I could say I could go for a workshop.
Did you ask to put it on?
It's one of those. I mean, there are definitely pros and cons with this. You know, obviously, the con is that there's no more buffer, and that you know then allows, you know, it limits our ability to grow into that area. Which you got to be careful about saying that, because the people out there don't want us to grow into that area right now. But you know, 50 years down the road, you never know what the environment may be. So it does create a fence line. You know, it does. You know, the downside is that with the recent census numbers, I think we're 197 people over that $10,000 mark, which cuts us off from USADA or USDA funding, rural development funding, and puts us into a higher category for, I think, stormwater controls and some other things as far as regulations go for us. And there's 250 people in that strip. So, you know, the benefit would be reducing the population by that amount. That would be a short-term fix, though, because, you know, at the next census, you know, unless something very strange happens, no matter what, you'd think that we'd grow back over to 10. So, I mean, I think it is something that, you know, we haven't talked about it a lot lately. We talked about this issue a lot with the redistricting, and you guys did redistrict a plan that has it equalized out if you were to get rid of this strip. And I think we had one more workshop. Didn't we have another workshop on it sometime early summer?
On the strip? Yeah.
But I mean, we can.
That's where you did the pros and cons.
Yeah, we can definitely, you know, provide, because there. I mean, there. It is definitely one of those issues where, you know, for everything good about it, there could be something potentially bad. So something you definitely want to be comfortable with if you were to do it, because it's one of those things. The way it's annexed, you couldn't annex like this anymore. It's you know, that strip annexing you can't do anymore because it's not contiguous. So if you were to get rid of this strip, you could never get it back. So if you do it, you really want to make sure that it's, you know, but there are benefits right now, but again, there are long-term risks. So I would definitely recommend being comfortable with it before you took action.
All right. If everybody's in agreement with that, to pull it and then talk about it in depth.
Can we pull it?
Yeah. As long as we have a workshop. Yeah. Oh, yeah. We have a workshop if we're in transition.
Yeah, well, we can schedule it. And I think it's something, to be quite honest with you, I think whoever the new city manager is, I would like them to be plugged into this, because this is a big issue.
Yeah.
And I'd certainly like to have them at least on board. I mean, I don't want to pass it by 6 months away, but I think we need a little time to get them up to speed, take a peek at it, and understand the dynamic of it.
Well, and it's not necessarily, I mean, there is really no rush on it. I mean, it's not really hurting anything. I don't think we've started to see any kind of regulatory changes or anything. I know there is the issue. I know the USDA is going to cease lending rural development money in Guthrie, I think, starting October. That's the only downside, but I think it would take quite a while since those are census numbers to convince them that
that's why we have LCDs.
You know, so.
Well, I know I've got a group of calls from realtors that's the only way we can loan money. If they take that away from us, there are a lot of people not going to be able to have a home under $100,000. So
we need to take a loan.
We're talking about
some of that.
Talking about a huge group of people that we just got through talking about giving everybody jobs.
Right.
They're going to have somewhere to live.
Right.
So
there's definitely pros and cons of it, but we can just, you know, if you guys, you know, when you set it up on a workshop, whoever's here at the time, whether it's in the transition or whether it's with the new manager, you know, just make sure that they get you all the information you want.
Well, we can set it up as quick as possible.
We're adjourned.